Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I have a fun feature, my 1Kit 10 cards using the March card kit by Simons & Stamp that has just been released. I have announced that I will stop doing this feature, but I got so many comments and so many emails that I just have to jump into it again. Thank you all so much for all the love that I am getting. So first let's take a quick look on what's included in the March card kit by Simons & Stamp. First of all, you get two colors of ink cubes in colors that coordinate with the theme of the kit. You also get a bag of these little pom-poms, and there is a little bunny stamp that you can use that on top of it for his tail. Now, you also get three envelopes. Two of them are shiny, as you can see, and the other one has a lovely wood grain texture. I don't know if you can tell from the video. Now, you also get the Glitter Gloss Aqua Shimmer pen. This is by Tonic Studios. Just take out this ring and throw it away, screw back the pen, and you are ready to go. I've been using this pen a lot for my projects, adding shine on top of them, and I'm always happy to get one extra. I don't know if you can tell how shiny that is, but you have to try it out to see that it's even shinier than Wink of Stella. Now in this kit you get two stamp sets, so this is an exceptionally awesome kit. You get one which is called Choose Joy and the other Showers and Flowers. So you get lovely flowers and great images to color in, such as boots with flowers inside, a little bunny, and a little duck playing in the rain. I think you will really enjoy those stamp sets. You also get 12 pattern papers. These are both double-sided and lovely, lovely designs. I think these are actually by Cartabella, and from their Spring Market collection, and I just love some of those pattern papers. You will see that I am creating my 10 cards using the most of these papers, and I love that you get a solid paper as well as some more intricate designs. I'm going to browse them through so you can see what's included. And now let's put those aside and bring in the stickers. So get lots and lots of stickers that I will be using and show you how you can use them to create lovely cards, really quick and simple and with great results. Now you also get a bag of these three pre-folded, pre-scored envelopes. So I'm going to take them out. They are in a cream color, which I absolutely love, and it goes great with the colors of this card kit. So you get three of them, and I will be using those as my card bases for my 10 cards. And let's take a quick look on the colors of the cardstock included. There are 5 different colors, so you can create 10 different card bases if you wish so, including these three that they are already pre-scored. So let's start with card number one. For my first card, I'm going to use this pattern paper that has all those tags with the flower images, and I'm going to separate some of them. You can use your paper trimmer, you can use your scissors, just cut out some of them for the first card. And I have also cut out a piece of this wood grain pattern paper where I'm going to stamp my sentiment. I'm stamping with Versamark ink, and I'm going to apply some white embossing powder, and my sentiment says bloom where you are planted. And now all I'm going to do is to add some foam squares at the back of all those little tags, and I'm going to stick them on top of my panel, 3 in a row. Now you can also embellish them even more and add some string through the holes, like create tiny little holes and tie bows on top of them if you want to add even more texture. But I think it looks beautiful as it is. And look how gorgeous the back of this pattern paper is. Sometimes you have to sacrifice with double-sided papers. So anyway, my card is ready, and you will find more photos on my blog as well as at the end of this video. So now I am going to use the scraps of the first card, or at least what's left from this gorgeous pattern paper, and I am going to combine it with this solid green pattern paper. And I'm going to create a panel that will go on top of my beautiful pattern paper there. I am using the twisted stitch borders to give this beautiful scallop edge. And you can use any scalloped edge that you have. It's going to give a beautiful look. So now I'm assembling my card on top of my craft card base that I have created. And as you can see, I have added on the top panel some tape adhesive at the top, but where the scalloped edge is, I'm going to add some foam tape, which is going to keep it slightly raised. So there is a little bit of dimension where the two papers meet. For the sentiment, I combined two sayings from the stamp sets, and my card reads, "Thanks for always being so delightful." So it's a thank you card, really quick and simple, but it makes a great use of that wonderful pattern paper scrap. And when it comes to quick and simple cards, you cannot go quicker than the card that I am creating now. So all I'm going to do is to use this beautiful pattern paper. This is just gorgeous, and I think that you don't really need to do a lot when you are working with such pattern papers. So all I'm going to do is to stick it on one of my vanilla cream card bases, and as you can see, my panel is slightly smaller than the standard card, so I have a lovely border that finishes the card beautifully. And I'm also going to use one of the stickers included in the kit. I have added my powder tool, the one that I use for my embossing powder, at the back, so that removes the stickiness. And this way I can use some foam squares at the back to raise this against the background and add some extra dimension. And this finishes this simple card that reads "Live Life in Full Bloom," a lovely spring card to send to all your friends. Now here is this leafy pattern paper that I absolutely love, but to use it I have to sacrifice the back. I was debating for a minute there whether I want to do it or not, but I decided to go for it. I am going to cut out a panel slightly smaller than my standard card. I'm going to stick this panel on top of a green card base that I have created with the cardstock that was included in the kit. So you see again I have a lovely frame around my panel, and again I'm going to work with the stickers. I always get a lot of questions on how you can use the stickers or ideas on using them when they are included in the card kit. So that's what I will do today. I am going to use this lovely vase with the flower composition on top. Again, I removed the stickiness of the sticker at the back so that I can use my foam squares and raise that image just a little bit against the background. And I'm going to create a cluster there using thread and more stickers. So first of all, I'm going to create a bow, and actually I used this thread, I fold it three times so that I end up with a lovely fluffy bow. And so I'm just going to tie that there. I'm going to go with that green sticker that says smiles, and this is actually going to be my sentiment, so no stamping on this card. As you can see, I have used a tiny little foam square on one side of my sticker just to level it up with the rest of the stickers there. And now I'm going to put down the bow. I used some glue dots to make sure that it stays in place. And now finally I'm going to bring in one more sticker to ground somehow my vase. And you can put that on top of your vase as if it is standing on a shelf, but in my case I'm not going for a very realistic look here, so I'm just going to put it at the back underneath, and my card is ready. And now let's move on to a very clean and simple card. For this card I used the white cardstock that was included in the kit to create my card base, as well as to cut this panel. So now all I'm doing is using stickers, and I'm going to combine them to create a lovely cluster of flowers on one corner. And then I'm going to stamp my sentiment. This is going to be a very clean and simple card, but at the same time it's really gorgeous and stunning. Depending on the sentiment that you are going to stamp, it can be very versatile for pretty much any occasion. I used foam squares at the back of this panel to put my card together, and then I used a black VersaFine ink to stamp my sentiment. But remember, don't do it as I did. First stamp the sentiment and then put your card together. It was quite scary to stamp on top of all this bulk, but I got lucky at the end. To finish off my card, I added some dots with my Nuvo Drops, and my card is ready. Now for the next two cards, I will be working at the same time, so I'm choosing two images. One is the boots with the flowers and the other is the little duck. I'm working on a watercolor paper and I'm going to stamp those images at once. I'm using black archival ink just because I will be working with watercolor later on to color both my images, and I'm actually stamping on the rough side of my watercolor paper. I just love that texture and look, so I am going to end up stamping twice just to get a lovely crisp image. Now I'm going to show you how I colored one image, and I did the exact same technique for the other image as well. So all I'm doing is applying my watercolor with the shimmer pen that was included in the kit, and this is going to make sure that the whole image is going to be super shiny. Now the colors I'm using are actually my Aquaflow pens by Tonic Studios. I have applied a little bit on my glass mat and then picking it up with my clear shimmer pen. And you can do the exact same thing with any watercolors that you have. Instead of using any brush that you have at home, just use the brush that came with your kit. It's going to look terrific at the end, trust me. And I did the same technique for every part of my image. So I moved to the blues, and then I'm going to color pink the umbrella. And notice that I am keeping everything quite simple, not a ton of shading or anything crazy there, just applying my color with my brush pen. And so here are both my images ready to go. I'm going to try to and catch the light for you, and hopefully you can see how shiny it is just by using the shimmer pen instead of a water brush. So I'm working on my two cards at the same time. I'm going to stick those on top of the card bases that I created using cardstock from the kit. And I'm going to do some finishing touches, just to add that extra something on both of them. So for the one with the boots, I am adding some white Nouveau Drops at the white dots of my boots. And for the card with the duck, I'm using Glitter Drops by Nouveau, and this is the Aquatic Mist. It actually is has glitter inside. I'm creating some dots, which I am later going to use a pointy tool, and I'm going to drag the top to create a little droplet. So these look as lovely raindrops. Now, as always, you will find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. And let's move on to the next card. Now, for this card, I'm going back to using the pattern papers and the stickers so that I can give you even more ideas on how to use them. I have cut out a panel out of this gorgeous pattern paper, and now I'm also going to use this beautiful sticker. Again, I'm going to remove the stickiness from the bag using that pillow I use for my embossing. So this is not sticky at the bag anymore, and I can use my foam squares there. Now, just to embellish it a little bit more, I'm going to bring in some ribbon. This is actually seam binding that I'm going to cut out to size and thread it through that hole. And I'm also going to use some foam squares at the back so I can stick that on top of my card. And then I'm going to bring in some green thread and tie a bow around my seam binding. And it's always lovely to add bows and ribbons on simple cards because they add that extra texture and make them more special. For the next card, I'm using this pattern paper with the light wood grain design, and I'm going to cut out a circle. So I end up with a panel that I'm going to stick on top of my card base. Notice that I am applying the adhesive only at the edges, the outside edges, since I want to tuck in things inside that circle, that window. I have also cut out a little ring using one of the pattern papers, the one actually that has a wood grain on top of it. I used my white glue at the back, and I'm going to stick that on top of my panel. Now this white glue I'm using, the Nouveau glue, is going to dry clear, so no worries if you have a little bit of a mess here and there. Now I'm going to bring in some stickers, and I'm going to tuck them inside that window. And this is a very neutral colored card that you can hand out to everyone who loves gardening, especially now that spring is coming. I think it would make a lovely gift to give this card along with some seeds or a plant that they can plant on their garden. Now, the sentiment is also a sticker, a lovely sticker that says happiness blooms from within. And I'm going to embellish my card just a little bit more by adding some brads at the sides of this sticker. There are already some holes there, so I just had to add something there. I'm just poking a couple of holes. Now, I don't mind if I can see the back on the inside of the card, the back of the brads, but if that bothers you, you can always set the brads before you stick the sticker down. So this is going to make sure that it hides them. And let's move on to the last card for today. For this, I'm going to use some scraps, some leftovers that I have, like this gorgeous pattern paper that I used in a previous card. I'm going to stick that on top of the gingham pattern paper, making sure that I align it in such a way that the borders are pretty much the same. And you have a lovely background where you can add any focal point from the sticker album. Now I decided to go with this watering can, and you can see that I managed to tear it off somehow as I was peeling it off. But anyway, I'm going to put back everything together, and it's not going to show since I am planning to stick on top this lovely flower bouquet. Now for this, I'm again going to remove the stickiness from the back and use some foam squares so I can add some dimension on my card. And for the sentiment, I will go with one of the stickers that says fresh flowers. And here is a photo of the last card, and let's take a quick look on all the cards that I have created, making the most out of the March card kit by Simon Says Stamp. Now I have a giveaway on my blog, make sure to visit and leave me a comment, let me know which one of the 10 cards was your favorite, and I will pick a winner and announce it on my blog. So now let's move on and see what's left from the card kit. So I do have the two stamp sets, my Aqua Flow pen, the two inks and the little pom-poms that I haven't used for my stash. And again, I want to show you this bunny where you can use those pom-poms. It's going to look super cute and adorable. Now I do have the envelopes that I haven't used. And I am going to show you that I do have two more card bases, since I used some of the pre-folded ones. I have a few leftovers and four pattern papers that I haven't used at all, although I tried to make the most out of the pattern paper and the stickers. I do end up having lots of stickers as well. So these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun, you got inspired, and don't forget to visit my blog and enter your comment for a chance to win this card kit by Simon Says Stamp. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.